bless you. Those of you who have your Bibles, turn with me quickly to Psalm 74. Amen. They have one translation on the monitors, but I'm going to be reading from the Message Bible. It gives you a clear understanding of what the writer is saying in this particular psalm. All right? Psalm 74, beginning at verse 1. Oh, that is it, isn't it? Praise God. Amen. You walked off and left us and never looked back. God, how could you do that? We're your very own sheep. How can you stump off in anger? Refresh your memory of us. You brought us a long time ago, your most precious tribe. You paid a good price for us, your very own Mount Zion. You actually lived here once. Come and visit the site of disaster. See how they're wrecked. They've wrecked the sanctuary. While your people were at worship, your enemy barged in, brawling and scrawling graffiti. They set fire to the porch, axes swinging. They chopped up the woodwork, beat down the doors with sledgehammers, then split them into kindling. Then burned your holy place to the ground, violated the place of worship. They said to themselves, we'll wipe them all out and burn down all the places of worship. There's not a sign or a symbol of God in sight, nor anyone to speak in his name. No one who knows what's going on. How long, God, will barbarians blaspheme, enemies curse and get by with it? Why don't you do something? How long are you going to sit there with your hands folded in your lap? Audacity to talk to God like that. But God is my king. He shifts right here, verse 12. God is my king from the very start. He works salvation in the womb of the earth. With one blow, you split the sea in two. You made mincemeat of the dragon tannin. You looped off the heads of Leviathans, then served them up in a stew for the animals. With your fingers, you opened up springs and creeks and dried up the wild flood waters. You own the day. Here's where I want to. You own the day. You own the night. You put stars and sun in place. Verse 17. You laid out the four corners of earth, shaped the seasons of summer and winter. Amen. I wanted to just read verse 17, but it would not have made a lot of sense. So I read 16 verses so I could get to verse 17 to let you know that he shapes your summers and your winters. So I want to talk about guard your summer. Amen. If he shapes the summers, if he owns the summers, if he made the summers, then you ought to guard your summers. Father, in the name of Jesus, bless your word today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of our God. Turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, guard your summer. Guard your summer. It's important to guard your summer. How many know that there are some people in here today that had a bad summer years ago and have never recovered? They have never recovered. How many know that what you do in the summer, what you do in the summer, you can make it or you can break it? The summer can set you back or it can propel you forward. The summer can be a good experience or it can, young people, it can be a bad experience. The summer, amen, can be high or it can be low. Church, summer is a wonderful gift from God. Somebody say, thank God for the summer. Amen. The beautiful warmth of the summer and all that we see. Amen. The flowers that have now bloomed. Amen. And this summer is a major place for us. The prayer in this summer. He talks about some things about the summer. The summer is a time of renewal and refreshing. And so we praise God for the summer. Let me give you a quick synopsis of this 17 verses of the 74th Psalm. Literally, it starts out with a prayer for God to remember his people. Then the enemies have destroyed the places of God. Enemies defied, amen, defiled, and they oppressed the church, the sanctuary. And then there was a question that comes up, how long will you allow them to taunt us? Amen. And abuse us. They declare that God is king. And then literally he closes out and says, he also tells us that God is the sovereign creator. That means that he created the summer and the winter. How many know that God is at work in the summer? I said he's at work in the summer as well in the winter. He's at work. And since it's summer, amen, and God is at work in the summer, then it's a good thing for us to guard our summer. Are y'all with me here? And so the word summer, y'all, has many connotations. And when we think about it, amen, beaches. Anybody been to the beach lately? Oh, I got one or two people that's being honest. Amen. And so it's beaches and ice cream and sunshine and, amen, to the parks and to walks and rides and all of those things. I never shall forget living in Kansas City, Missouri, growing up there, that it was hotter than hot in the summers. I mean hot, hotter than hot. It was so hot we could see the rays coming off the pavement. And then when we see the rays coming off the pavements, as young people would do, we'd go in and get some of mama's eggs and then... Ain't nobody done that but me, huh? Amen. We would get an egg and crack it open and see if we fry it on the... It was that hot. It was that hot in the summer. But we loved summer because the fire department was friendly then. They would come around in our neighborhoods and turn on the fire hydrant. Amen. And we'd play in the fire hydrant half the day. Wasn't nobody worried about the water bill. The government was not worried about the water bill. Do I have a witness here? Amen. We enjoy the summers. Summers, different connotations for the summer, y'all. Summer, late nights under the lights. Late nights under the lights. Summer for some of us was road trips and family reunions. And how many know that summers, longer days, summers have many connotations. There are summer storms and summer slumps and summer survivals, summer vacations, summer staycations, summer disappointments. There's the summer of joy, the summer of love. Summer has a lot of connotations. And so much so that you need to guard your summer. God is the God of the winter and the summer. Amen. There's a correlation between the physical and the spiritual. Things lie dormant in the winter and things come alive in the summer. Amen. Things move slow in the winter, amen, and fast in the summer. And so we celebrate summer by guarding our summer, y'all. And so when the summer changes, amen, how many know that the summer, when it rolls around, it seems like a lot of things change? Are y'all with me? Can I tell you that, amen, that people's attitude change from winter to summer? Folks have a different attitude in the summer than they do in the winter. Amen. How many of you know that folks will jump bad in the summer? Y'all gonna get this in a second. They'll jump bad in the summer because, amen, they can sleep out on the park bench, but they won't jump bad in the winter. They have a different attitude. Help me, somebody. Amen. Put me out in the summer. Amen. I'm all right. I'll make it. But the winter is a different. And so attitudes and people do things different. Amen. People get into shape in the summer. Some folks do. And then people change their attire in the summer. In the summer, they wear just about any, no. In the summer, they don't wear anything. Help me, somebody. Amen. Amen. I saw a couple of them yesterday. They don't wear too much in the summer. In the summer, but the winter, we're fully clothed. Well, how do we experience God in the summer, Pastor Jones? Somebody say, a little more God in the summer. That's what we need, a little more God in the summer. And so we remember that the psalmist says that summer was made by God. You shape the summer. Amen. He shaped the summer. That means he shapes everything that's about us and that goes on in our lives in the summer. Summer is the time where we experience God in several aspects of our lives. Let me give you a few things and I'll be finished. I just want to just prompt somebody and stir somebody up and get you thinking about your summer. Summertime, amen. Summertime is the time we experience God in our free time. Let somebody say free time. Amen. We experience God in our free time. Why? Because in the summer, we leave the busyness of our winter schedules at the time. Amen. When the momentum of life is literally interrupted. Amen. And so we praise God. How many of you know that even the free time that you have, God gave it to you? And so we experience God in the free time. Somebody will be happy about the free time that you have. You ought to thank God that you've got some free time in the summer. We praise God for it. So if you have free time in the summer, then what are some of the things that we ought to experience in our free time in the summer? We ought to experience God in how we think. Let the church say think. And so we address seasons of our lives. Summer season, it's a season when we ought to be more mature. We began to experience life's realities and life's challenges and life's trials. We deal with education, and whether it's college or, amen, on our job or some other area, we deal with careers. We deal with our careers, what kind of career we want. We deal with marriages and raising our children. During the summer of our physical lives, we began to think about what we want out of our lives. And how many of you know that if you live long enough, you'll recognize that there are seasons in your life, and the winter season of your life is very different than the summer season of your life. And the summer season of your life, you ought to be more mature. Amen. Physically and spiritually, there ought to be a maturity about you in your life. How you spend your time and how you think. Where you want to go. Anybody thinking about what you're going to, amen. How many of you know that what you do in the summer can mess up and blow it for the rest of the year? And so you ought to begin to think about some things in the summer. You ought to be thinking about. And so summer is not just a time, amen, for you to sit back and relax per se and do nothing. But it's the time for you to think about some things. Somebody say think. Amen. Think about what you do. Think about where you go. Think about who you connect with. Think about how you spend your time. Amen. Think about the 7 days of week. You ought to think about some things. Summer is a time, amen, for God, amen, calls us to think and to remember some things that God has done in our lives. Summer is a time that you think. And how many know that when you begin to think about how good God has been to you, you begin to bless the name of God. It is not a time to take a vacation from God. And so a whole lot of people believe that summertime is a time, amen, where you retreat from the worship experience. But how many of you know in the summertime, as literally, it's the time where you begin to build up some things and set yourself in place to be a winner and be successful toward the end of the year. Is there anybody here that say, amen, I'm thinking about not just July and August, but I'm thinking about December. So how am I going to end up based on what I do in the summer? Some folks don't do anything in the summer, and you play and catch up, and you never catch up. Do I have a witness here? I'm just trying to be practical and help somebody out today. Amen. It's a time, amen, where we experience God in our thinking. We experience God in our thinking. And so summertime is a time to pray. Yes, it's a time to pray. We will establish a prayer. We're going to establish some prayer lines. I've time to interject this. You'll be getting that real soon, that all of our preachers are going to be given an hour. Amen. A.M. or P.M. There's going to be a time. We're going to give it to you on next Sunday. It'll be on the monitors. There'll be a phone number. There'll be a way that you connect with one of our preachers where you can spend time in prayer. 5:30, 6:30, 6 o'clock, 8 p.m. You're going to have time in prayer. And let me just say to you, because I don't have time to give you all the instruction, it is not a time to tell folks, amen, what's been going on in your life, what you are doing, what's going on, who you mad out, who your mama is, what your birthday is. It's only for time of prayer. Let the church say prayer. It's a prayer, prayer, prayer. That's it. Amen. 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 1 says, therefore I exalt, amen, first of all, that supplications, prayers, and intercessions and giving thanks be made for all men. And so guess what? You're going to pray for everybody. Somebody say everybody. Did I say everybody? You pray for everybody. Your enemies. Help me somebody. Amen. You pray for folks you know, folks you don't know. Amen. And let me just say to you, you can't take up all the time in your prayer, because it's only going to be about 15 minutes at most. And so you can't pray for 5 minutes. So get your prayer in and let somebody else get their prayer. I don't have time to give you all instructions, amen, when we start. So I got to give it to you now in my sermon. And so you say your prayer so the next person can shout and say their prayer. Do I have a witness here? And how many of you know that, amen, that person on the other end doesn't even have to know about what you're going through, but the Spirit of the Lord knows. And he will plant that in that person's spirit, amen, and cause them to speak things in your life that you haven't told anybody about. And so it's a time of prayer. Amen. And so summer's a time of prayer. It's a time to think. It's a time to study. We study through devotion, y'all. Find you a devotional. Find a place where you can study the Word of God. You don't have to spend 30 minutes. You can spend 5 minutes in devotion. And how many know it'll bless your life? Find you a devotional partner. Somebody that you can share with. Amen. And y'all share the Word of God, and it will help you along the way. Am I talking to anybody in here? And so it's a time of fellowship. Let your say fellowship. Amen. Fellowship with people who challenge you to live better. It ain't, fellowship is not all about chit chat. It's a time for somebody to challenge you to live a better life. Amen. In the earth in which you live. Am I helping anybody up in here? That's the kind of fellowship we have. So summer, we experience so many things. It's a time to think. It's a time to reflect. It's also a time to, amen, to rest. Let the church say rest. Amen. How many know that in the Bible talks about rest and talk of the great creation story? The Bible talks about that when God made the earth, in 6 days he worked. In the seventh day he went. He rested. He rested. Amen. He rested. And praise God for the rest that he allows us to experience. In summer's rest, we meet God in the seventh day, y'all. The God of rest. Well, amen. Here is how we rest. Literally, passage of scripture in Psalms 46:10 says, be still and know that I am God, says the Lord. That's how you rest. Be still and know that I am God. God's people are committed to be still. The imperative gives a solemn duty to those in covenant relations with God. So in conjunction with this text, literally, it lets us know. It gives us the idea or the thinking behind being still is not to restrict our mobility. Amen. The duty represents a spiritual disposition, the character or the habit. It speaks of us as finite and him as infinite. And so literally, it boils down to this, church. It's what they call a calm confidence. And how many of you know that you ought to rest and have a calm confidence and knowing that God is going to take care of things that you can't take care of? Am I helping anybody in here? Well, let me put it in this terminology. A whole lot of y'all, amen, because y'all like slang and all that, literally saying chill out. Chill out. Amen. How many know that there's some folks that are just too busy, they too wrapped up and caught up and stuff? There comes a time on the seventh that chill out. You've done your work. Do I have a witness here? And so there comes a time in your life you need to what? Chill out. Look, the reason why folks are not chilled out, because they're trying to push God to do stuff for them. They're trying to hurry God. Thank you, Mass Choir. Chicago Mass Choir says you can't hurry God. He says, no, you just have to wait. Trust and give him time, no matter how long it takes. He's a God. You can't hurry. You don't have to worry. He may not come when you want him, but how many of you know that he's always on time? Job says, I got something to say about that song. Job was sick so long until the flesh fell from his bone. His wife, cattle, and children, everything he had was gone. He said, you put these afflictions upon me. Why don't you come and see about me? He may not come when you want him, but he's always. So you can't hurry, God. I want to tell somebody, chill out. God knows what he's doing. He knows what you're going through. He knows what you need. Do I have a witness here? Don't get all tied up in knots. Amen. Because you can't do anything about it. I told you, you're finite, but he's infinite. That means that you're limitless. Amen. You're limited and he's limitless. That there's no degree, no stopping under him. And so you have to make sure that you rest in him. Turn to your neighbor. Tell your neighbor, chill out. You're going to run into somebody this week. Amen. They're going to be rushing in their mind and rushing in their bodies, rushing in their conversation. You tell them, chill out. Amen. Summer is a time of rest. We're going to wait on God. And when God is ready, God will deal with our situation. Well, praise God for rest in the summer. I said, praise God for rest in the summer. Amen. Parenthetically, let me just drop this in on you, because how many of you know for the first 6-7 months of the year, there are a whole lot of things that happen in our lives. And so July and August gives us an opportunity to rest, amen, and to reflect. Amen. Some things in life, the first 6 months, there are some things that has happened in your life that you need to take ownership of. It wasn't everybody else. Maybe you're in the state that you're in because of what you did or what you said. Amen. And where you went. Do I have a witness here? And so you've got to take ownership. And so maybe in July and August, you're taking ownership of some of your. Do I have a witness here? Amen. And so chill out. God will straighten things out. Praise God. Somebody ought to look forward to September. Wow, we're going to have a great September if we learn how to, amen, let God allow us to guard our summers. And so summer, we experience God in how we think. We experience God through our rest. We experience God, amen, a God who works. How many know that he works? In the summer, he works like a farmer. A farmer tills the ground long hours. A farmer, amen, literally understands what it means to work hard and rest on the seventh day. A farmer knows what the summer really means. He's aware, watch this, of the rhythm of life and how the seasons come and go. And so how the God of the summer is bringing forth fruit in due season. And so how many of you know that that's what happens in the summertime, that he's done his work those first 6-7 months of the year. And so in the summer, he's bringing forth fruit in due season. Listen, y'all, he's working while you're resting. Amen. Somebody shout hallelujah. But not only is he working while you're resting, he's working while you're praying. Help me, somebody. Somebody ought to shout on that one, because when you look at it, while you're praying, he's already working. While you're praying, he's already at that location. While you're praying, amen, he's already turning things around. Help me, somebody. And so that's the God that we serve. He's working while you're praying. He's working while you're studying. And God knows he's working while you're thinking. And how many of you know that you can think some stuff? Amen. I said you can think some stuff and God will do it on your behalf. Amen. Think on these things, those things that are lovely and kind. Amen. Understand, summer is the time I'm finished to experience the grace of God. Somebody say, thank God for his grace. Amen. We experience the grace of God, the favor of God. When you look back over your life and look how you've made it through the first 6 months of the year, amen, it's a time to experience the grace of God, nobody but God. How many know that we do a whole lot of foolish things in July and August, and we are here today because of the grace of God? Somebody say, thank God for his grace. Amen. Some of y'all, July, I haven't even got here. You already started out doing some foolish stuff, doing some stuff you ain't got no business doing, saying some things you have no business saying. But thank God that we experienced the grace of God. How many know that he's a keeper in the summer? I said he's a keeper in the summer. Because in the summer, we began to relax our standards. We began to relax what we know, our devotion unto God. But thank God for His grace. Somebody said, thank God for His grace. And so every morning, grace begins to wake us up. And so I want to just leave you with this. Just because we are the recipients of the grace of God, how many of you know that we ought to experience, or we should exhibit what I call some random acts of kindness. And if God has been good to you, then you ought to be good to somebody else. Praise God. Well, here, and I'm almost finished. This is what you ought to do in the summer. In the summer, amen, young people, learn this. In the summer, there ought to be some random acts of kindness. Here it is. Buy a movie ticket for some person that's behind you. Random acts of, pray for somebody's meal, amen, at a restaurant. I ain't getting no help here. Amen, 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 amen. Hold the door open for somebody to come through the door, even if they don't say thank you. Amen. I've held a whole lot of doors. Ain't nobody said nothing, like I'm the doorman. But how many know that God will bless your random acts of kindness? Amen. Leave money in a vending machine for somebody. Bake some cookies for the elderly. Serve at a homeless shelter. Let somebody go in front of you or in line. Give a stranger a compliment. You don't have to know them. Do I have a witness here? And you don't have to be hitting on them. You ought to just give them a... Do I have a witness here? Amen. It's the summer. We ought to do some things in the summer that dictates that we spend some time with God. Amen. In the springtime, leave time. Leave some time on a parking meter. Buy flowers. Amen. And hand them to somebody for no reason at all. Do I have a witness here? Amen. Just say kind things to somebody. Help me, somebody. Amen. Come to church like you want to be at church. Do I have a witness here? Amen. Unfold your arms. Random acts of kindness. Amen. Lift up holy hands unto a holy God. Do I have a witness here? Open your mouth and out of your bellies, give God a praise that He's never heard before. Random acts of kindness. Here it is. Here it is. Why don't you write an encouraging note and put it on somebody's windshield? And when they pull it off, tell them God loves you. Do I have a witness here? Amen, amen. Do some things all because you got to guard your summer. And how many of you know that what you do in the summer will carry over into the winter? I wish I had some witnesses here. It'll carry over in the winter, and you'll find the end of the year, amen, being blessed more than the first part of the year. It's what you do in the summer is how you're going to reap in the winter time. Is there anybody here under the sound of my voice that know that God will do it? We need some summer worshipers in the house. Somebody that will say, I'm not going to miss a Sunday of worship, amen, because God has been too good to me. He's blessed my life. He's blessed me in my going out and my coming in. He's blessed me in my down setting and my uprising. Every time I turn around, He keeps on blessing me. Hey! Bless the Lord of the summer. Glory. 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 Guard your summer. And so here it is. All that I've said, literally, amen, is to help somebody and to tell somebody, you will not mess up my summer. Because I'm going to be kind to you. I'm going to think the right thoughts. I'm going to pray during the summer. I'm going to spend some time in the Word in the summer. I'm going to make sure that I'm in worship. Do I have a witness here? I'm going to make sure that I have random acts of kindness. And you watch your disposition in September, October, November, and December be better than the first part of the year. That's all. I'm finished. I just wanted to prick somebody's conscience to let you know that God shaped the summer. And he wants to shape your summer. Hallelujah. So that you'll have a testimony. Praise God. You'll have a testimony. You'll have a testimony. That the God of the summer encouraged me to guard my summer so that I have a prosperous winter. Are y'all with me? Come on, everybody standing. Everyone standing, wherever you are. Bless his name. You're here, man, woman, boy, or girl. You're not in Christ. You're not in church. Praise his name. We extend the invitation for you to come wherever you are, whoever you are, in the balcony, on the main floor. So we're praying with you and praying for you. And so this is to help us not to have what I call a summer slump. You're here, man, woman, boy, or girl. You're not in Christ. You're not in church. You're not in Christ. You're not in church. Wherever you are, man, woman, boy, or girl. If you're here today, you want to give your life to Christ, you need a covering, you need a church home, come wherever you are. We're certainly happy to see Evangelist Johnson here. Praise God. She's an example that God is a healer. He'll heal you. He'll heal you. Man, woman, boy, or girl, wherever you are, come, come, come. Come, come, come. Come. Praise God. All right, let's do this. Let's do this. Those of you who want God to impact your summer and that you want to have the wherewithal to guard your summer, let's come pray about it. Let's pray about it together. Whatever it is that you want God to do, yes, in the balcony, if you just come as close as you can to the front and take your neighbor by the hand, if you just kind of spread out or get close, wherever you are, to your left, to your right, where are you? Amen. That's right. That's right. That's right. My prayer is that you will not experience a summer slump. That you will not. I didn't say all that I wanted to say, but a lot of churches experience a summer slump in attendance, in finances, and otherwise. So if the church is being impacted that way, it suggests that the individuals are being impacted that way. And my prayer is that we'll break that cycle. We'll break that cycle. It is not a time for us to be immobile, but we rest while we are still yet coming and being refreshed in worship and study and all of those things that bless our lives. And you watch God take care of you. Let's pray and agree together. Father, in the name of Jesus, we love you, we thank you, we praise you, we magnify you and adore you. Thank you for the privilege of reminding us, even from the word of God, that you own the summer, you shape the summer, which means that you will shape what we commit to you. And so God, we commit our summer to you right now. We acknowledge that our summer belongs to you. Bless us in every walk of life, God. Guide us and direct us. Help us to think the right thoughts, yet even during the summer, God. Help us to pray the proper prayers, God, even in the summer, God. Help us to study those things that will help strengthen us spiritually and otherwise, God. We thank you and we praise you, God, for the time that is ours to rest and relax. And may it be fruitful, God, and revitalizing as when we return in September. And so, God, now other matters are before us in prayer. I pray right now, God, that you will speak to those who need healing. Touch bodies, those who have been weakened by this world and life and living, God. I just pray in the name of Jesus. Build them up right now. I pray, God, that you will do what the doctors have not been able to do. And then help us to come alongside of the doctors, God, and remind them that they're just practicing physicians. But we know the great physician who's able to heal, God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, God. Where there's lack in the summer, give your people creativity to do things that will help their summer. Amen. To be prosperous in a way, God, that's pleasing. May they not lack anything in the name of Jesus. I pray for our young people that they would not do anything foolish in the summer. Stop them right now in the name of Jesus. Build a hedge around them, God. Prick their hearts and their minds, God. May they be reminded of the words they've heard in worship and in study and from their parents. Oh God, we thank you. So we pray right now, stay the hand of the enemy. He has no rule over our children and our young people, God, and even our lives. We bless you and we thank you. Guide our footsteps, God. Forgive us of any sins that we may commit. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for what's ours to receive. We thank you and we praise you, God, that not only will the S-U-N shine in the summertime, but the S-O-N will shine in the summertime in our lives, God, and bless us and give us the desires of our heart. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, God. Cover and keep us. Hear our prayer, God, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.